call to order this public work session of the Mahwah Board of Education for August 7th, 2019. Would you please take roll call?
Mr. Kismorski. Ms. Conico.
Here.
Dr. Morth. Mr. Wendrickwitz.
Yes.
Ms. Sikkone.
Here.
Mr. De Silva.
Here.
Mr. Gallo.
Here.
Mr. Coppin.
Here.
And Ms. Barron.
Here. Adequate notice of this agenda of this meeting has been provided to the Ridgewood News and the Record specifying that the Mahwah Board of Education will meet on August 7th, 2019 in the Administrative Offices, 60 Ridge Road, Mahwah, New Jersey. A copy was filed with the Township Clerk. Mr. Wendrickwitz, would you like to lead us in the salute to the flag? Please rise.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, may I have a motion to recess to executive session? Mr. Kismorski, second by Ms. Conico. Okay, may I have a motion to reconvene? Mr. Gallo, second by Mr. Coppin. Thank you very much. Agenda questions. Please limit your questions at this time to resolutions under new business on this agenda. As a matter of fairness, you are asked to limit your questions to no more than one and your remarks to no longer than 3 minutes. If you are here representing a group, please identify yourself, the group, and your position in the group. If you are here as an individual, please give us your name and address. This section of public participation will be limited to 15 minutes. Please specify the resolution you are referring to in your question. May I have a motion to open to the public? Mr. De Silva, second by Dr. Morthy.
Evelyn Slackbauer, 43 Thunderhead Place. 17S, do we have an estimated time of completion?
Tomorrow,
traffic lights. It's got to be the traffic
council meeting. Mike Kelly is going to report substantial completion on September 6th. It is unlikely that that will happen.
Okay.
It might happen. The guy, if you notice, they were putting footings in.
Yep.
They are expeditiously moving. So
okay.
We would be hopeful of an early start.
Okay. And then 17CC, the AP2D Art and Design Curriculum, was that completed or not completed? It will be completed for the school year.
Yep.
Okay, great. Thank you.
No problem. Anyone else? Okay, thank you. May I have a motion to close the meeting to the public? Ms. Conico, seconded by Mr. De Silva. Thank you, Dr. Schoen. Do you have anything for us this evening?
I do. Just a couple of things. We had the opportunity prior to our meeting this evening to visit the STEAM building, which I would say at this point is about 95-96%. Complete. I think that the board's reaction was incredibly favorable. It is a beautiful space. Mr. Fair and Dr. DeToro were there on their computers staging what it could look like when it really does come to life. They did a great job. They now have a second job. But it really, really came together, and a lot of that work is certainly a result of our maintenance staff that's here as well. We took over the building a couple of weeks ago as far as cleaning is concerned and those kind of things. The landscaping is coming together. A real big shout out to Brian Brisby, one of our parents in town. It was through him that we were able to get landscaping done around the building, and the fact that it was done in the hottest time. But he put some bags around the trees, and our maintenance guys have been real diligent about watering them. We anticipate them growing fruitfully over the years. Once the rest of the landscaping has been graded, a majority of it has been, they will do some hydro seeding. So we'll have a little time before some grass comes up. But we're really reaching the final moments, and it certainly looks that we will be well on our way to opening for our students. We anticipate doing some kind of opening, grand opening, ribbon cutting, that kind of thing, once the building is in operation. We don't want to rush that the last week as they're doing final details. I want to be able to work with our community relations committee and talk about how we're going to publicize that and what that looks like, but we'll do that probably in September. So the STEAM building is coming along great, as are all of our other facilities. Our maintenance crew is really doing an outstanding job getting our buildings in order. The facilities committee was just at Ramapo Ridge. And although it looks a little crazy right now with the cleaning going on, it really does come back together for September 5th. Just circling back to the stop arm systems on our buses, if you recalled, we approved a resolution for that. They're in the process of being installed on site as we speak. Going back even further to some of the recommendations from the police department, we talked about numbering our buses on their roof. So if there was a helicopter and they needed to find the bus, they'd have the ability to pick it out. They have all been now numbered. So that's in the process of taking place, so all of our buses will be equipped with that stop arm system, I anticipate, by the first day of school. So other than that, doing well.
To that point, I met with Shapizi last week and brought that up again with her, saying what's happening.
You're looking for legislation that would make all bus companies do the same thing, right? Because one of the things that we mentioned worthy of note again is that we can only control what we do with our buses. We could not go out. We could try to bid for that, but the majority of companies don't have that, and then we wouldn't have buses for our students. But at least our, how many do we have, Kyle? 15?
Buses? About 12.
12, okay. So at least the 12 buses that we have are equipped with that. It's certainly a beginning. Have to start somewhere. So other than that, doing well?
Yeah. Mr. Bleeker, first this evening.
The only other thing to mention is the follow-up from last week. I mentioned that last meeting that the audit was beginning. This week the orders are still here. They're wrapping things up. Just want to take a moment to real quickly thank the business office, child study team, all central office really. The auditors don't just focus on things in the business office. They do touch a little bit of the areas all throughout the school, throughout the district. So thanks to everybody, support staff, for helping out, give them what they need so they can do their work. They should be wrapping up the field work the next day or two. Takes more time for them to do the report following, but we should begin the report sometime in the fall for the finance committee to review and then to present to the full board. That's the only other item to report on.
Thank you. Mr. Fair, do you have anything for us this evening?
Yes, I do. I have to report on two items. Our first is our retirement, Resolution 18D, for Gaynell Ferber. She's a secretary at Lenape Meadows School. School secretaries wear many hats and are experts at multitasking throughout their day. And for over 20 years, this has been Mrs. Ferber. Gay has taken on many roles within the office, and throughout her day, she welcomes parents into the school and answers their questions, spends time each day speaking with staff members who are like family, and works with the HSO to make sure that events are scheduled and materials are ready. We wish Gay a wonderful retirement that is full of health, happiness, and time to now spend with her grandchildren. Agenda item 18K, I just want to wish Cheryl Epstein the best of luck in her new position.
Thank you very much. I have nothing for this evening. So do you have any board committee reports tonight?
You got one for policy. We have 17V. There are two regulations and a policy. And if Lauren wouldn't kill me, I would drop the mic. Because that's it. We're done until we're starting with the new series, but for this year we're done.
We're done.
In our meeting in July, I mentioned to the board that the Community Relations Committee coming back to you with our draft of our mission statement, and you have in front of you the copy of it. Normally, I'd say it's affecting your intelligence by me reading it, but it's important enough to us that everyone understands what we did with this. Very proud of this document, so I'm going to read it to you, and so everyone can hear. The Mahwah Board of Education believes that the Mahwah schools are an integral part of the community, and the community support is necessary for the district's operation and achievements. In order to maintain productive relationships, the board's Community Relations Committee is dedicated to sustaining effective, accurate, and meaningful communications with the community. The Community Relations Committee establishes the following goals: to facilitate dialogue with the community, to increase public understanding of the district, to ensure the community is aware of the district's goals and initiatives, to increase community confidence, interest, and involvement in the district, to promote effective dissemination of information concerning district activities, and to encourage the sharing of resources among community organizations and businesses for the benefit of the district. We are very proud of this, and we hope if you have any other suggestions, just get to one of the members, and we'll look at it. We have a meeting coming up on this Friday at 8:30.
Thank you very much, Mr. Meyer-Gretz.
Thank you.
Yes, this is going back to the policies. I guess this is for Dennis or Dr. Schoen.
I'm just curious, who is our district wellness policy coordinator?
That's actually a combination of Mr. Bleeker and Jack. I can't remember Jack's last name.
Petruniak.
Jack Petruniak is the manager who works directly for him.
Just real quick, from the technology committee, John Pascal sent the email out last week to all high school families with regards to the one-to-one program. I forget the exact dates, as I don't have it in front of me, but the important things to remember are to go on to real time after the 12th and answer the questions, and then go on to pay for it and pay the insurance fee before your students pick up their own computers, otherwise they cannot. So just a reminder.
This week.
It's next week is when you're able to.
20th, 21st, 22nd.
Thank you.
Would John mind if we just stop by to see the computer exchange?
I will let you try that with.
Wow!
You can bring your pet lion with you.
I will not be attempting that.
And I'm not even on the technology committee, so I have really no standing.
A few items from the facility committee. This morning we met with Downs Tree Service to finalize the scope of work for the playground renovation and to discuss the schedules. The scope of work has changed slightly in that most of the rubber chips will be removed and covered with 12 inches of certified wood mulch, which will be ADA compliant. So we've met all our goals in terms of being ADA compliant, cleaning the playgrounds up, and also the impact absorption of the material will be meet all the standards required for the equipment that we do have. And it is anticipated that that project will be completed by the beginning of school. I also draw your attention to 17S, which is the traffic light project. A pre-construction meeting was held last Wednesday, and as of this Monday, there were shovels in the ground. I also want to extend a thanks to our partners at the town council for approving a resolution to amend the cost-sharing agreement, and 17S is our portion of the cost-sharing agreement, and I encourage all board members to vote in the affirmative on that item. It's essentially a $25,000 delta on our side, well worth the cost for the safety of our students, in my view, and also the view of our traffic engineer expert. I also want to thank, before the last couple of meetings, the committee has visited a number of our schools. We visited all the schools except Betsy Ross and GW, and I want to thank all the principals and staff who escorted us and kept us from going crazy in their buildings. It's remarkable that our buildings and ground staff keeps our buildings in relatively good shape. There are some opportunities for improvement in our buildings, which I think we'll be talking about over the next few years. And It's sort of important, you know, we have the big steam building project going on, and it's sort of a showcase. This year we're going to either award or complete between $4.5 and $5 million worth of work without going to the taxpayers for bond money and sort of an extraordinary assist. We did this by prudently managing our district's resources over the number of years, and we've made substantial improvements in our facilities as a result. Do we have more facility improvements to make in the future? Absolutely. Our tour today was at Rampo Ridge. Just sort of my view of things is there's a lot of opportunities for improvement at Rampo Ridge. We have a great administrative team over at the Ridge. We have great faculty at the Ridge. We have great faculty throughout the district. And we are focused on providing our great staff with great facilities to do wonderful things for our students, and we have more to come. Just on a totally unrelated measure to finance facilities, on September 16th, the Mahwah Marching Band will be performing at Meadowlands with the Jets game, and I encourage as many of you and your friends to attend and support Mahwah, and if you're a Jets fan, support the Jets. Or Cleveland.
I would do just for the band.
There you go.
Who's the Jets?
They exist. That's my report.
Board members have any remarks, additional comments on other items?
Yes. Again, Kyle, thank you very much for your facility report. It was factual. There was no sugarcoating. You told us what was up and what was down, and we appreciate it. Second thing is the mentoring program. I read the mentoring program, and I noticed the last sentence that it appeared to the year before and the year before. If you have any ideas for improvement, please write them down. Does this report this year reflect any of the previous suggestions for improvement, or were there any?
The suggestions for improvement year over year really spoke to continued work together as a team for more time together. So we're going to look to see if we can create some more opportunities for the mentors and mentees.
So there's no changes of emphasis requested?
No areas of focus.
Okay. I attended an education leadership workshop on August 1st in Trenton. There's another one coming up on the 14th. It runs from 9 o'clock in the morning till 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Well worth it. It was excellent, and it's free. Good for the mileage. And finally, Faye Ferber. I knew Faye Ferber when she was a board watcher years ago. She would keep us honest. She'd come to every board meeting and go, no, 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 or yes, yes, yes. She's come a long way, and she's been great for this district over these years. I've known her for about, I would say, 20 years now, and she has been great as a secretary and as a board watcher.
Thank you very much, Ms. Wendrickus. Next time, I would appreciate if you have any questions to direct it to either district administration or myself instead of to someone who's sitting in the audience. So I appreciate that. Thank you. Yes, Brad.
Regarding the playgrounds, do we know how much of the rubber mulch is going to be removed, and are we still
capping? Virtually all of it, and there will
so
be
there won't be a cap, or
there will be a fabric over there, and essentially that fabric will now prevent weed growth from underneath the playground.
Okay. So, a substantial amount of rubber mulch, and how is it going to be disposed?
It gets contractor is disposing it.
Okay.
Doesn't require
so I know it doesn't require anything special. I'm just
right. They're going to be taking out as much as they can without getting on their hands and knees and picking up.
Yeah. So there'll be still some crumb. Some of the material will still be remaining.
Right. Yeah, under a foot of wood chips.
Yeah. A blizzard of wood chips.
Mm-hmm. So the original idea of encapsulating it, that's, we're not doing that now.
No.
We've modified.
Okay. Modified.
Thank you very much.
But the good news is the project is we have an assurance that it will be completed before the start of school. So,
I'm looking forward to seeing how the wood chips are pounded down to make them ADA compliant. I can't quite grasp that vision as to what they would look like. So maybe I'll come and watch when they do it. So thank you.
I think
thank
they're
you.
Starting in a week or two,
all
something
right.
like that. So.
Thank you very much for that update. Mm-hmm. Anyone else? That's good. Okay. I'd like to take 16A, motion to move on 16A and B. Business. Mr. Gallo, second by Mr. Wendrickowitz. Please take roll call for that.
Of course. Mr. Kaczmarski.
No, standing on 16A. Yes.
Ms. Conico.
Yes.
Mr. Wendrickowitz.
Yes.
Ms. Saccone.
Yes, on 16A and abstaining on 16B.
Mr. De Silva.
Yes.
Mr. Gallo.
Yes.
Mr. Coplin?
Yes.
And Ms. Barron?
Yes. Now I'd like a motion to move on 17A through FF. May I have a motion to proceed? Ms. Conico? Second by Mr. De Silva. Any questions, comments on any of those items? Yes?
No? Just include me on the vote. It's okay.
My apologies.
It's okay. It's happened before, so I'm just only because first time I thought, I'm late, so you can't include me. But now I know that's wrong. Okay. No worries.
Okay. Could
you take a little
more? I'll come back to
Doc.
For 17A, Mr. Kaczmarski.
Yes.
Ms. Conico.
Yes.
Dr. Morthy.
Yes.
Mr. Wendrickowitz.
Yes.
Ms. Saccone.
Yes.
Mr. De Silva?
Yes.
Mr. Gallo?
Yes.
Mr. Coplin?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm abstaining on 17A. Check number 095935.
We're losing it.
And I thank Brett for the assist.
17A, 17F, Ms. Barron?
Oh.
Yes.
Okay,
hold on.
I vote yes, but I'm abstaining on 095990.
Go back to 16A, Dr. Morthy, for the minutes.
16A is a yes, and B is an abstain.
To have it on the record.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now I'd like a motion to proceed on 18. I have 18A through proceed, Mr. Kaczmarski, second by Mr. Any questions, comments on any of the items?
Mr. Kaczmarski?
Yes.
Ms. Conica?
Yes.
Dr. Morphy?
Yes.
Mr. Wendrickowitz?
Yes.
Ms. Cone?
Yes.
Ms. Silva?
Yes.
Mr. Gallo?
Yes.
Mr. Coughlin?
Yes.
And Ms. Barron?
Yes. Public questions or comments. This section of public participation will be limited to 15 minutes. May I please have a motion to open to the public? Mr. De Silva, second by Dr. Morphy.
Go ahead, ladies first.
Oh, boy.
Jesus.
Evelyn Slackbauer, 43 Thunderhead Place. I just wanted to find out, did you have a chance to look to check and see about the mercury and whether it was included in any of the polyurethane or the rubber surfacing that was included in our gym floors?
You want me to do it, Kyle? Or? So the material that's in question that is leaching the mercury was discontinued sometime in the 80s or 90s.
Right.
The two gym floors that have this rubberized type material were both installed within the last 10 years. We've contacted the contractor who put them in. He's provided us the MSDS sheets. We followed the Department of Health guidelines on doing this kind of follow-up. It is highly unlikely that any of our floors have the mercury-contaminated polyurethane. I think it's called AME.
Okay, great. Yeah, I was aware that two of the gyms were renovated after that date of 80, but I wasn't sure if there was anything else that would have included it. Okay.
Yeah, because I believe it just affects those rubberized types of floors.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Okay, great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Congratulations. I saw on Facebook.
Who you are. Where do you live?
John Feason, 20 Falcon Court, Mahwah, New Jersey.
Thank you.
And tonight I'm representing a group. I'm representing the Mahwah Museum. And I'm a trustee. And my position as a trustee is membership chairman. You now know why I'm here.
I'm a member.
I'm a member as well.
But first, let me say congratulations. I saw on Facebook that the Mahwah School District is number 19 out of 162. That's pretty good.
We're getting there.
You know, so with all the problems Mahwah has, that's a shining light, as the steam building is. I hope that the board really makes a big, big deal about it, because we've had coyote problems and everything else. We really need some positive things going on in Mahwah. So tonight, I would like to give you the opportunity to fill out an application for membership at the Mahwah Museum.
Where's the no soliciting sign?
You talk about community relations.
There's no doorbell to ring.
What's better than the Mahwah Museum, where the history is all kept? And I know that Michael and
Ms. Barron.
Him, yes. I'm getting older. Are members, and I'm not sure if anybody else is a member, but I think everybody is.
I'll make sure that each one of the board members gets it.
Thank you very, very much.
And there's a lot to be said about the museum, and to me, it's the cornerstone of our history of the town. A lot of people don't understand where the museum is. So as membership, I gotta get 26,000 people to join and be a member of the Mahwah Museum. So I'm starting out with you people, because you're my best friends.
Mr. Peason, are you okay if I make a copy of the front and back of this, put it on our website under community events?
Sure.
And see if anybody, because I think at least download it and consider doing that, and we can do that with the community type thing related to Mahwah. Is that okay with you?
That's fine with me. The more the better. I got 26,000, so.
We get an ice cream party or something.
But do we get the VIP membership if we, like, is it the first?
We solicit?
12,000 get VIP status?
They're telling me they're going to raise the membership dues in September. So now
the discount is till August 30th. Okay.
And it's only $15. I mean,
Pete's going to join for sure.
Check the air in your tires.
Pete, that was an easy lob. That was a yes, community relations chair.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yvonne Beatrice, who is one of our extraordinary educators at the high school, retired a number of years ago. She's now involved with the museum as well, and she ran her students through something called the Mahwah Project every year. So the students had to research some aspect of Mahwah's history, and that touched, no doubt, upon the museum's activities. But there's a lot, actually, to find out. Mm-hmm.
Hi, Dave.
Hi, Dave.
Hi, Dave. Hi, Dave.
Yep. Who are you? David May, 93 Oweno Road, Mahwah. By the way, Mr. Friesen has a great annual barbecue at his house.
If you get an invite, definitely.
Oh, I bring it up at every council event.
If you sign up for the museum.
We thought we're the best friends.
What I wanted to ask was if there, I brought it up at a previous meeting, and just wanted to see if there's any conversation about it. Start times at the schools.
You did bring that up.
Just wanted to know if that's even being talked about.
To be honest with you, we have not talked about it. I'm not going to tell you their conversations and then have nothing to report in a couple of months. There are so many implications to changing the start times at the high school. As much research that says a kid should sleep a little bit longer, and I'm sure we'd all like that a little bit more. The implication on starting at the high school would change all the other five buildings. So we haven't discussed it yet. And to be honest with you, I don't know how many towns out there have considered it and or changed it.
We could be first.
Princeton is it? I haven't.
I believe I read that Princeton is starting this year, is changing their start times.
I'll certainly talk to John about it, because you're specifically talking about the high school, right?
Yeah, I mean, just think about it quickly. I just think elementary schools maybe start earlier. Just flip flop them. Start the elementary earlier. Start the high school later.
That is certainly an idea, Mr. May.
Who knows?
Thank you.
No problem. Thank you. And then we're talking about visiting the schools and the facilities. I have to throw out there, Betsy Ross needs a real gymnasium. Hopefully that's on the list.
It might have been on the list.
All right, great.
Considering a lot of things.
Yeah, it's definitely a need. So that's it. Thank you.
Awesome.
Thank you, Mr. May. Anyone else? Okay, may I have a motion to close to the public? Mr. De Silva, second.